differentials or diffs. Our 8-scale off-road buggies have three diffs, one in the front, one in the center, and one in the rear. Most on-road cars, they have two, one in the front, one in the rear. Two-wheel drive off-road cars have a rear differential because the rear are the driving wheels. The front wheels don't have drive, there's no front diff. Regardless of how many differentials are in the car, the basic principle of how they work is the same. What the differential does is it allows either the left and right tire or the front versus rear tires to turn at different speeds. Why is this important? Well, if you remember when we talked about steering geometry and driving around a corner, you remember we were talking about how the inside tire has to turn more than the outside tire because it's driving around a tighter arc. Well, that also means that the inside tire is turning slower than the outside tire in that corner. So the inside versus outside tires in a corner need to be allowed to turn at different speeds. That's what differentials allow the tires to do. In the previous chapter, we discussed shocks and how the damping and the springs enable us to control how the load transfers while we drive the car around a track. And by doing that, we can manipulate the balance of the car. We can get the car to handle the way we want, and we can adjust front to rear balance if needed by adjusting the damping or the springs. Differentials are similar to shocks in this way, because while shocks help us control load transfer, differentials help us control power delivery. In a similar way, we can affect the balance of the car, the feel of the car when we drive around the track, in regards to how the power is delivered. Now I'm going to give you a really good rule of thumb. And if you understand this, it will make adjusting your differentials a lot easier. Because differentials affect power delivery, it makes sense to break it down by looking at on-power handling and off-power handling. When we think about the car off power, so no throttle input, the car is just rolling, how do we make a car stable in that situation? Well, if we don't allow the tires to turn at different speeds, if you try turning the car, it won't want to turn. It doesn't want to allow the front tires to begin turning at different speeds like it needs to when the car corners, so the car wants to push. The same is true for the rear tires and also front versus rear axle. All those tires need to be allowed to turn at different speeds so that a car can efficiently corner. So if we have an unstable car off power, so it's very nervous and twitchy, if we go to thicker diffs, the car will be more stable. So if you have a problem where your car is really nervous, let's say you're on a high grip track and your car feels very aggressive and nervous off power, if you go to thicker differentials all round, your car will actually be more stable. So off power stability, go to thicker diff oils. Now the opposite is true, of course, if you need the car to be more aggressive off power. If your car is too stable, too lazy off power, and you need it to turn into corners more, rotate through corners more, then you would go to thinner diff oils all round. Then, if we talk about on-power driving, let's say that you have a problem where off-power your car is just fine, but when you get on-power, it seems to be too difficult to drive. What tends to happen is you get on-power and you have to be careful, because if you get on-power too much, the car will slide out, the rear end will slide out, and you'll be drifting down the track. So in this situation, if you want to make the car easier to drive and more stable on power, you would go to thinner diffs. Then on the other hand, if your car is very easy to drive on power, but you feel like you don't really have enough drive, and maybe your car is very easy but a bit slow, you would go to thicker diffs all around, because then you'll have more drive on power. So just remember this basic principle of off power, thicker diffs are more stable. On power, thinner diffs are more stable. This is a very good general rule. So if you are at the track and you are having a problem, pay attention to when that problem occurs. Does it occur off power, where thicker diffs could help solve that? Or does it occur on power, where thinner diffs could help solve that problem? Before we move on and start talking about each diff separately, I want to complicate this just a bit. There's something that we call diffing out. What diffing out means is that one or more tires are so lightly loaded that they start turning really fast. You see, the way a differential works is that as we apply power and the wheels start driving the car forward, the differential will allow whatever tire has the least resistance to begin turning faster. This is actually why we use silicone oil to adjust the hardness or thickness of the diff, the resistance internally to the gears turning inside the diff. Because if we didn't have any oil in the diffs, this diffing out would occur all the time. So as soon as you start accelerating, the front tires get lighter and there's more load on the rear tires. Well, in that situation, all the power, all the drive would go to the front tires and the front tires would start spinning. So you would be losing drive because of this. This is actually why the car is easier to control or with thin diffs on power, because you actually have less power at the driving wheels. So that the tires that have the most grip, less power is going there. They're driving less. So this way the car maintains more even traction. So to stop this diffing out from occurring too much, where let's say the inside front tire is in the air when we are exiting a corner, and all the drive would go to that inside front tire and it would be spinning really fast in the air, and the tires with grip wouldn't be receiving the driving force. To stop this from happening, we use silicone oils in the diffs. The thicker you go, the harder it is for the diff to start working and for that tire that's in the air in this situation to start diffing out. So what I want to add to this conversation is that on a high grip track, what can happen if you are running thin oils is that your car is easy to drive up to the point that it starts diffing out, and then that is what makes it unstable. So on a loose track, it's almost always the case that if you go to thinner diff oils, your car will be more stable on power. But on a high grip track, if you go to thin oils, not only will the car will be But on a high grip track, not only will the car... But on a high grip track, not only will the car be unstable off power because it's nervous, it will also be unstable on power because now it will start diffing out too much. So on high grip tracks, thicker diff oils are actually better on and off power. So that's a sort of exception to the rule. But anyway, let's move on and talk about each diff separately.